Hey, Irish people. A lot of people went ask me if I heard about this case in Dallas. Yeah, I heard about it. They stole like 10 horses or something. And Texas is still a felony to steal a horse. So it's still a pretty serious crime. But of course, these teens that the media likes to say when they don't want to say who did it. Oak Cliff area is a, let's say, a high crime, high gang area. But all the kids that stolen were 14, I think 15 and 16, maybe 14, 16, 17. Let's listen to a story here.
Questions to be answered about how a group of teenagers stole three racehorses and rode them down the street before a deadly crash early.
This is pretty interesting, too. They stole these horses. It wasn't the guy's saddle, so they brought the saddles that they had on the horses. And these horses, according to the owner, have never been ridden. He only uses them for pulling a cart, which is very odd that they were able to get on them with saddles and walk away. I'm thinking insurance fraud or scam. This just seems a little too convenient that these people came into this guy's area and brought their own saddles. Nobody knew it was odd. Never met a horse before, put a saddle on it and rode them away, and they're all teens. This case does not pass a smell test for me.
This morning. Hello and good evening again. A 14-year-old is dead tonight after he and two other teenagers were hit by a car as they were riding stolen horses. It happened about 5:30 this morning along I-45 and Great Trinity Forest Way.
So 5:30 in the morning, they're on a highway, which means they had to get there like at 4 or 4:30. So nobody's feeding these horses. Nobody's going out checking on the horses. This guy's talking about their race horses and they're hard and he goes away and he does all this work. Yet nobody, there's no camera. There's nothing for all these expensive horses that I'm sure he's going to claim that are dead now.
East Oak Cliff. Two of the three stolen horses are dead as well.
The horse owner tells me he was watching the news this morning and he knew deep down inside that the horses were his. What he didn't know is that the person...
I always watch the news, and if I hear a horse stolen, I think it's mine. Really? You watch the news and find three horses stolen, and just deep down, you don't even see the horse. You don't even know your horses are missing. You haven't checked on your horses, but you just had a feeling they were yours? Red flag.
Lost their life was only 14 years old.
Well, I didn't realize that he was that young. He was 14-year-old. Yes. They make some bad choices, and I'm kind of the victim of it, bad choices.
Lorenza Gooch owned the three horses stolen by three teenagers that were hit by a vehicle on Great Trinity Forest Way at I-45. A 14-year-old died. Gooch lost two of his three horses.
6-year-old Gillen, Waco Sasser Kid, and a 2-year-old Payson Philly, Belly Wine.
So a 2-year-old horse that's never been ridden, these kids were able to saddle up and ride them down the highway. Doesn't pass the smell test.
Me up.
The East Oak Cliff interchange was shut down for hours.
They had everything blocked off. They let us in because we were on the corner, and that's when we saw the horses and the one guy in the street.
Scott Riegler works nearby. He thought about the consequences of what happened.
Somebody's going to have to get that phone call this morning that their son's not coming home.
Police.
Yeah, that's it. You got three teens out at 4 in the morning, and the parents really care about where they're at or what they're doing, knowing they're out there committing crimes. Yeah, okay. They're going to really have to get a tough phone call.
It was a hit and run, but the driver did stay on the scene and has not been charged.
This poor little horse, he didn't do anything, and he...
Stay on the scene and...
So, if the other two were died, he was probably knocked down or skinned. I think the guy, either in this article or another one, said that he had injuries and scars from either being hit by the car or knocked on the ground.
Has not been charged.
She was either fell or something hit her. She scarred on the right side, a little sore in the hand.
We caught up with Lorenza Gooch and his third horse, Logo Winner, at Lone Star Equine Hospital. The teens were riding in saddles, but Gooch says the saddles were not his. He races his horses.
Saddles weren't his.
Is on the pro circuit.
They have never been ridden. Are we poorly sucky?
Never been ridden. And these guys got on three horses that were never ridden with saddles that they brought that somehow just fit, and they were riding them away in the middle of the night.
I call the circuit. We have a jog cart and we have one we call a racing a bike. I race in Iowa and Minnesota. I leave normally.
Look at the huge bit on this horse just standing here.
The summer and basically gone all summer.
This is the first time Gooch has had horses stolen, but Alman Livingston has had his horses stolen twice. Each time he tells me recovering them.
It's a sentimental value to me.
Lorenzo Gooch says after this, he thinks he's done with horses.
Oh, so right as three horses of his get stolen that have never been stolen, that people brought their own saddles, he's deciding to get out of horses.
It's enough obstacles than trying to race horses and enjoy the sport and have your horses stolen and lose them this way.
This guy's not much of a horseman.
Be concerned about
holding a chain.
Someone stealing your horses and abusing them after they steal them.
Bad way to hold a horse.
Be concerned.
Got his finger all wrapped up in the leash, chain there, horse rears, get spooked. Not much of a horseman in my book.
About someone stealing your horses and abusing them after they steal them.
So a 16 and 17-year-old on those stolen horses with the 14-year-old, they were taken to a local hospital. Dallas police have said not much else about their condition.
All righty. So that's the big horse caper that we're not getting a lot of information. Want to learn that there?